Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 10.1, Problem 6. This is Section 10.1, Problem number 6. It says that Gary's wife, Doubting Debbie, feels that her husband's average monthly gambling losses are at least $500. Help Debbie set up a hypothesis test. So you may remember from the previous question, Debbie's husband, Gary Gambler, says that he only loses $300 or less every month. His wife, Debbie, thinks it's $500 or more. So let's set up a test for this one. What is the null hypothesis? So the null hypothesis will have the symbol capital H subscript 0 for null hypothesis. You put a colon, you put mu, you put a symbol, and then it's the number that you're testing for, in this case 500. You want to see if the real average for the population, like for every month there is, that it's what compared to 500? So it says at least 500 means 500 is the least. The real number is that much or bigger. So Debbie's claim is that the real average for monthly gambling loss is 500, equal to 500 or larger than 500, like maybe 575, 600. So its mu is greater than or equal to 500. That's what we mean by at least. It goes in the null hypothesis. The null hypothesis always contains the condition of equality, whether it's equality just by itself with an equal sign or combined with an inequality that has the or equal to in it, like this one. So now, what's the alternate hypothesis? The symbol would be capital H for hypothesis with a subscript of 1. We put a colon, we put the mu for population average, the same number, the number in the null and the alternate should match. And now the symbol would be less than. It's essentially the opposite of what the null hypothesis is. Now, part C, is this a left, right, or two-tailed test? Well, to determine that, what you want to do is look at the inequality symbol in the alternate hypothesis. So for this question, the inequality symbol in the alternate is a less than, which points to the left. So this is a left tail hypothesis test.